हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर मैथ क्लास। इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव लर्न ट्रांसवर्सल एंड पैरेलल। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ट्रांसवर्सल एंड प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 6.2 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक। लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गिवन देयर। इन द गिवन फिगर find the value of x and y and then show that AB parallel to CD. First we will find the value of x and y. Okay, so children, by linear pair this is 50 degree and this one is given x and this is given y, that is 130 degree. So children, here x plus 50 is equal to 180. How? X plus 50 is equal to 180. How? Because these are linear pair. So what you will write here? By linear pair. Okay? If x plus 50 is equal to 180, so what is the value of x? X is equal to 180 minus 50. That is 130 degree. So x is there, we get x is equal to 130 degree. Like that, here y is equal to also 130 degree. How? Y is equal to 130 degree. This vertically opposite angles, in theorem 6.1 we proved vertically opposite angles are equal. Okay, so y is vertically opposite of 130 degree, that's why they are equal. So by vertically opposite angle, so here children, x and y both are 180 degree, it means x is equal to y. So x is equal to y is equal to 130 degree. So here from figure, x and y both are alternate interior angles. So alternate interior angles are equal. If alternate interior angles are equal, it means these lines are parallel. So AB parallel to CD. Here alternate interior angles x equal to y, so AB parallel to CD by theorem. If a transversal intersect two lines and angles alternate angles made by them are equal, the lines are, then these two lines are parallel. This is theorem of 6.3. This is theorem number 6.3. So by theorem number 6.3, we get AB parallel to CD. Question number second. That is, in the given figure, if AB parallel to CD, AB parallel to CD, and the CD parallel to EF, CD parallel to EF, and the Y is to Z, ratio is given Y is to Z equal to 3:7. So find the value of. So children, since AB parallel to CD parallel to EF, we are given that AB parallel to CD parallel to EF, and this line is the transversal. And here given that Y is to Z equal to 3:7. So let Y is equal to 3X and Z is equal to 7X. So Y and Z, children, this one,
So what would be this angle? If this is z, so it will be z. Consider that is a, so a is equal to z by alternate interior angles because CD is parallel to EF. So children, since a is equal to z by alternate angle, okay, if it is z, so it will be alternate. So now y and z both are linear pair. Y and z both are linear pair. So y plus z is equal to y plus z is equal to 180 degree by linear pair. So children, y is we consider that is 3x and z we consider that is 7x. So 3x plus 7x is equal to 180. So 3 plus 7 that is 10x is equal to 180. So x is equal to children 18. What is the value of x? That is 18. So we can find the value of x, that is 18. So what is the value of y? Y is equal to 3 multiplied by 18. Okay, x is substituted by 18. So 18 3 ja 54. Okay, now 7 z is equal to 7 multiplied by 18. So 18 7 ja 7 8 ja 56, 7 on the 7 126. Okay, so we get the value of y and z, but we have to find the value of x. X is there. Okay, so children, y and x both are co-interior angles. As we know that interior angle of same side of transversal, x and y both are interior angle of same side of transversal. So you know that sum of interior angle of same side of transversal, that is 180 degree. Means this is also a theorem. Same side of transversal, interior angle of same side of transversal, that are supplementary. So x plus y is equal to 180 degree. How? Because x and y both are supplementary. X and y both are angles which is same side of transversal, that's why they are supplementary. X and y are supplementary. So x we have to find y, value of y that is 54 degrees. Okay, is equal to, not the degree is not there, 180 will be there. Okay, so 180. Now x is equal to, x is equal to 180 minus 54. Now x is equal to 126. We get value of x. So what is the value of x? Value of x, that is 126 degree. And you can find the value of x by corresponding angles. Z is equal to x also. Z is equal to x. If z is there, 126. So z is equal to x. So it is also x is equal to 126 degree by corresponding angle. Because x and z both are corresponding angles is here. Okay. Given that in the given figure, this figure is given. If AB parallel to CD, AB parallel to CD, and EF perpendicular, EF is given there, that is perpendicular to CD. It means that angle is 90 degree. And angle GED, angle GED means this one. This whole angle is given there 126 degree. So we have to find angle AGE. Angle AGE. This angle we have to find. Okay. And GEF. GEF. This one angle we have to find. Okay. As well as we have to find angle FGE. FGE. This angle. Children, let's see. Angle AGE is equal to angle GEF by alternate angle. So angle AGE, angle AGE equal to angle this angle and this angle, both are equal because EG is a transversal of a parallel AB and CD. So is equal to angle GED. So angle AGE is equal to angle GEET, that is given 126. 126 degree. Okay. How? By alternate angles. Now we have to find angle GEF, this angle. Okay. So children, angle GEF plus angle EFED is equal to angle GED. This angle plus this 90 degree. Total is 126 degree. It is given. Okay. So children, angle GEF plus angle FED is equal to angle, this is GED, total angle GED. Angle GEF, that we have to find angle GEF plus angle FED. Angle FED, that is your 90 degree, because FE is perpendicular of CD, so that is 90 degree is equal to GED. This is already given, that is 126 degree. Now we have to find angle GEF is equal to 126 degree minus 90 degree. When we separate, so what we get? We get 126 minus 90, that is 36 degree. Angle GEF, that is 36 degree. But next we have to find angle FGE, angle FGE, this angle. Okay. So children, easily you can find angle AGE and angle FGE, both are sum of these two angles, that is 180, because these two angles are linear pair. Okay. So now angle AGE plus angle FGE, that we have to find angle FGE is equal to 180 degree by linear pair. Angle AGE we found, that is 126. So 126 degree plus angle FGE, that we have to find, is equal to 180 degree. Now by transposition law, we transpose it and we get angle FGE is equal to 180 degree minus 126, that is 54 degree. So what we got? 54 degree. Understood?